Princess Mako just gave up everything to marry the love of her life. Who is Princess Mako? Born in 1991 as Princess Mako of Akishino, the Japanese royal is the eldest daughter of the Crown Prince Fumihito and Princess Kiko. That means her uncle is the Emperor of Japan and her dad is next in line. The princess started her life in Tokyo but later studied English at university in Dublin. Mako also has an education in arts, museum, and cultural heritage. Since 2011, Mako has taken part in her family's royal duties, attending official events and ambassador visits to countries like Brazil, Hungary, and Paraguay. The young princess was also a patron of the Japan Tennis Association. Her keen interest in other cultures took her on an academic program to Austria and architectural museums around the world. With her recent marriage, the princess gave up her royal title and prospects to the throne, all in the name of love and to become Mako Komuro. Meeting her not-so-prince charming. Princess Mako and her now husband, Kei Komuro, met nearly a decade ago while studying together at Tokyo's International Christian University. Some reports close to the couple say they've actually been dating since 2013. Mako later said of their first meeting, "First, I was attracted by his bright smiles like the sun, a sincere, strong-minded, hard worker, and he has a big heart." They decided to get married earlier, but the pair, however, became officially engaged for the public in 2017, much to the public and royal family's dismay. The couple's engagement continued privately while Mako did her master's degree out of the country. Controversy arose over the princess dating someone outside of royalty. Unfortunately, Komuro is considered a commoner by the royal family, and marrying him goes against the strict imperial protocol. Leaving royal life. The former royal's choices for love mean that she is technically abdicating from the royal family and her official position. Princess Mako has completely renounced her royal status in favor of marrying her sweetheart. Following the wedding, the royal family's imperial household agency submitted documents officially removing Mako from her royal status and official family duties. In Japanese royal culture, women are not in line for the throne, meaning that Mako's decision to leave royal life doesn't affect the line of heir. Getting married to a commoner does mean foregoing the tradition of royal princesses not having a surname. Taking her husband's last name is a big step for Mako, but shows that she's all in with her marriage and is willing to sacrifice some parts of her family's tradition for love. Regular wedding. Instead of enjoying the extravagance of a royal wedding with all the bells and whistles, Mako and her fiance got married in a low-key ceremony. The pair tied the knot at the family registry office in Japan, giving up all the usual glam of a princess's wedding. It was announced that an over-the-top wedding wasn't appropriate since not many people approved of the marriage. The college sweethearts celebrated with a subdued ceremony where Mako wore a pale blue dress, accessorizing with classic pearls, and Komuro wore a striped blue suit. After being followed by press and photographers for months leading up to the wedding, the former royal was likely glad to keep things to her inner circle. After the wedding, Kei Komuro made a statement saying, "I love Mako. We only get one life, and I want us to spend it with the one we love." Mako also defended her choices, calling her husband irreplaceable and saying, "Our marriage is a necessary step for us to be able to protect our hearts." No family fortune. Though it's frowned upon, the Japanese royal family doesn't completely disown members who decide to marry outside of royalty. Stepping down from royal duties, of course, means giving up your place in line to the throne and other perks of royal life. But the imperial family does offer a parting gift. Women who marry commoners and leave the royal family are offered a one-time payment of around $1.3 million. But Mako refused. The former princess is the first woman to decline the money when leaving the royal family for marriage. Family opinions. Even though her family disagrees with her decision, she visited them before the wedding, paying respects to her parents and sharing a long hug with her sister, Princess Kako. In the eyes of the media, Princess Mako was following the lead of former British royals Meghan Markle and Prince Harry, who stepped down from their royal duties for the sake of their family's mental health. The couple made headlines when they famously moved to California with their son and newborn daughter, leaving behind their royal status and roles in exchange for a quieter life away from media attention and fame. Like the case of Meghan and Harry, Mako and her new husband face scrutiny from the family and the public, some of whom are not supportive of their decision. She gave them a chance. Although Princess Mako and Kei were due to marry in 2017, they had to postpone the wedding due to a scandal involving Kei's mother's debts and their finances. When the couple originally announced their engagement, the abdication, paired with negative attention from the media and financial scandals in Kei's family, led Princess Mako's father, Fumihito, Prince Akishino, to disapprove of the union. He wouldn't even give his daughter his blessing to get married. Due to all the drama, the couple waited 4 years before actually walking down the aisle, giving Mako's parents plenty of time to come around and give their blessings. Press drama. After the announcement of Mako and Kei's engagement, the press came down hard on the young couple. Along with scrutiny from her family, they also had to deal with negative headlines and scandal stories in the press. The intense controversy and having her name in the papers led to Mako dealing with struggles with her mental health and eventually being diagnosed with post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. During the 4 years of waiting to get married, the former princess experienced side effects from all the negative press and had a difficult time dealing with the stress of the royal scandal. Luckily, the princess has her new husband's support. He told the press, "I feel very sad that Mako has been in a bad condition mentally and physically because of the false accusations." Mako also made a statement saying, "I am very sorry for the inconvenience caused, and I am grateful for those who have continued to support me." Who else left? With Mako's abdication, the Japanese royal family is down to only 17 members, down from 67 members back in 1945. After the current emperor, the line to the throne still includes Fumihito, Prince Akishino, the emperor's nephew, Prince Hisahito of Akishino, and younger brother, Masahito, Prince Hitachi. Before Mako, her older cousin, Ayako Moriya, also left royal life to marry a commoner. Ayako married her husband, Kei Moriya, but didn't face the same kind of negative feedback from the family and the public. Ayako's wedding was well attended, and she publicly thanked the country for their support in her decision. Ayako's older sister, Princess Noriko, also married a non-royal before that. Where to now? Now that everything is behind them, Mako and her husband can finally start planning for the future. The couple is hoping to start a family and wants to do that away from the media and public scrutiny. So, much like Meghan and Harry, the couple is moving to the US. Komuro is a graduate of Fordham Law in New York and recently passed the bar exam to practice law in New York. Mako can also put her museum studies degree to use in New York, with art galleries around every corner. As for plans for kids, Komuro stated, "Mako and I would like to build a warm, nice family. Happy times, unhappy times, we would like to be together, and we will be indispensable to each other." Mako agreed, saying, "Having a family still goes beyond my imagination, but I hope to make one that is warm, comfortable, and filled with smiles." Princess Mako of Japan is following her heart, even though that means giving up her royal title, future with the royal family, and her family fortune. Would you give up everything to marry the love of your life? Let us know in the comments and subscribe to The Thing Celebrity for more great stories.